Hi friends, this is Anuja from Yans Medical Academy. Today we are discussing about the living world. We are living in the world where there are millions of species living along with us. Actually, being a science student, we need to have clarity on what is living. Did you know, friends, what is the differences between living organisms and non-living organisms? Okay, let's discuss. Living organisms are grown, reproduce, and ability to sense their environment. But non-living organisms are can't do. Let's discuss about each character of living organism. First, growth. Second, reproduction. Third, metabolism. Fourth, consciousness. Fifth, diversity in the world. Let's start with growth. All living organisms are grown. The increasing the mass and increasing the number of an individual is considered the growth. One must remember, the increasing the mass of the body is called growth. Growth is also observed in two cellular forms, unicellular and multicellular. In unicellular, it may be synominous, and multicellular, it may be cell division. Growth is limited in animals but unlimited in plants. So, it is not a defining property of living organism. Next, we move to reproduction. Reproduction is nothing but reproduction is a characteristic of living organism. In multicellular organism, the reproduction is a sexual reproduction. Unicellular organisms also be reproduced, but some living organisms cannot be reproduced. For example, sterile workweek and infertile human couple. So it is not a defining feature of living organism. Next, we move to metabolism. Metabolism is considered as sum of all the chemical reaction occur in our body is called metabolism. It may be divided into anabolism or catabolism. No non-living objects or living things exhibit metabolism. So, it is a defining feature of living organism. Next, we move to consciousness. Consciousness is nothing but the ability to sense their environment or surroundings is called consciousness. Animals have sense organs. Plants have ability to stimulate external factors like temperature, water, and light. Humans have self-consciousness, so it is called a defining property of living organism. Next, we move to diversity in the world. We have a lot of diversity in the world, that is 1.7 to 1.8 million. The naming of living organism is called nomenclature. The naming only possible when an organism is described and we know correctly what name is attached to this animal is called identification. It is carried out by two forms, ICBN and ICZN. ICBN is called International Code for Botanical Nomenclature, and ICZN defined as International Code for Zoological Nomenclature. These also have some universal rule. The first rule is biological names are generally in Latin and written in Latinx. The second rule is the first word represented the genus, while second word represented the species. Third rule is, if you write to handwritten, write separately and underline. Fourth rule is, in first word, the first letter represented the capital letter. In second word, the first word represented the small letter. Sometimes the other name is also be seen. I will give you a small example, Mangifera indica. It is the scientific name of mango. In Mangifera indica, M is genus. It is represented the capital letter. In indica, I is represented the small letter, it is species. Sometimes the other name is also be seen, linen. It is the other name. Next, we move to taxonomical category. Many students are not interested to learn this sequence, but don't worry friends, I will give a small technique. It is very useful by studying. First, let me move to down to up in ascending order. Species, genus, family, order, class, phylum, and kingdom. In species, we see more fundamental and common characters are being seen. In genus, common compared to characters are seen. In family, both vegetative and reproductive characters are seen. In order, floral characters are seen. In class, more common characters and order to related characters are seen. In phylum, related to class orders characters are seen. In kingdom, it is the highest category of in this sequence. In ascending order, increases the dissimilar characters and decreases the common characters and decreases the similar characters. In descending order, increases the similar characters and increases the common characters and decreases this dissimilar characters. Okay friends, let's move to, I will give a small technique. Okay, let's start. In kingdom, K for kids. In phylum, P for play. In class, C for cricket. In order, O for on. In family, F for fine. In genus, G for ground on. In species, S for Sunday. Kids play cricket on fine ground on Sunday. It is very simple to learn. Okay, let's move to herbarium. Herbarium is a storehouse of collected plant specimens. These also providing sheets and also carrying label providing information and data collection, and these are useful for taxonomical studies. Next we move on botanical gardens. These are the places where collection of living plants are being seen. These also grown for identification purpose. These are also carried biological name and scientific name and its family and etc. The Royal Botanical Garden is present at Kew in England, and Indian Botanical Garden is present in Howrah, and National Botanical Research Institution is present in Lucknow. Next we move to museums. Museums are the places where wild animals, dry species are, specimens are be kept. These are mainly found in places in colleges and schools and etc. In museums, dry specimens and collection of skeleton muscles are being seen. Skeleton animals muscles are being seen. Let me move to zoological parks. These are the places where wild animals are being kept. In zoological parks, all living organisms are like animals are being seen. Children are allowed to visit in these places. Okay friends, the end of this chapter, I will give a small conclusion. I hope you all understand this lesson. Okay friends, here NEET examination, one or two questions are being asked. Don't neglect this chapter. Medical Academy wish you a good luck for NEET examination. Thank you.